Hey, you. Yeah, you. You watching this video. You clicked on this video because you want to know how to make a fucking wheel in Blender. Particularly a funny choo-choo wheel. And this is what it's gonna be. And so, like, I decided to make this video for, Big Man at Fan12Thomas, also known as Western on Twitter, he wanted to know how to make wheel. We're like, on Discord. So, like, I got you, bro. So now I'm gonna make a tutorial on how to make a wheel. So first off, you need your references. So let's just go with... There we go, we got a Thomas right there. Now, fucking hell. Now, alright. So I was going to essentially make a... You can make a... I mean, I don't need this right now because it's just a tutorial, but just so you understand the concept of it. So let's just bring it up. And when you put on your references, you're gonna have to, like, make it the wheels on par with, like, the tracks and shit, and make sure you scale your drawings right. Make your scale your drawings and references perfectly, otherwise you're gonna be fucked. All right, so where do we begin? Well, let's just go mesh cylinder, okay, and then we bring it over here. We go, so now it's transparent and shit, and then we bring it down, go bam, and then we go rotación. You rotate it 90 degrees to be nice, cool, and quirky. And then we just gotta scale it. Just like that. And just bring it. Alright, cool. Now that it's all quirky and shit, just bring the shit forward. Edit mode. Bring it like this. So now we have, like, an accurate diameter. Of course, when you're doing these drawings, you ideally would have, like, a separate pair of drawings like this. And you go like this. And then you scale it to, like, how the wheel actually is. And you're not, fuck it, let's do it like that. So let's bring it like this. And then we'll do it like that. Alright. So, this method of making wheels is how I personally make it. Other people might have different ways, I don't know, but this is how I make it. So first you're gonna, do the inset face, right? I think that was called? Yes, inset face. Then you gotta copy this number that you have in thickness. And then you gotta go to the other side, inset face, copy that same number, and then you paste it in, you paste it in. Then, go on to the other side, bring it in like that, and then you bring it in like that. So inset face, bam, and you paste that new number in there. So now I got this weird shit looking thing. Now what do? We select face mode, alt control these faces, so select all the faces, and then just delete the faces. Same for the other side. Alright, perfect. Now you got the rough outline. What are you gonna do, you may be asking? Well, you're gonna do some science. So, you see, you can select these two faces in the face set thing, and then press F to connect bridge the faces. Like, to create a new face. And then just press and hold F as it goes all the way around, and do the same on this top one. Select one of these, like two thingies right there, and then select this side and just press and hold F. There we go. Now you got a reverse donut. What's next? Well, we're gonna go in for the flanges. So what do? I go like this. I just select the thingy, my bobbers, and select this, and I go extrude a smidge. Then you shape, and like that. Now you see you got the flanges. And also, this is what I've recently begun doing. Bevel it. Now, remember, to select all around in a circle, you do Alt Control. Why isn't it working? What the fuck? Yeah, there we go. Or it's just Alt. It's just Alt, I think. Maybe very, I don't know. Can't remember. And then just Control V to bevel, and I don't know, let's just do like 3 seconds, whatever. Doesn't have to be too much. I'll just move that bitch. Alright, now what do we have next? We gotta do like the weird spokes. Okay, clearly didn't. Shit, balls. Hold up. There we go. That fits. And make sure that when you're doing that first, like, this blue part that I'm marking out with my mouse. I don't know what it's called, but like this part of the wheel. You mark it accurately to the drawings, so don't be stupid like I was right there. Then we're gonna do mesh cube. Got a cube, resize it, G so we can move it, and we bring it over here. And what are we gonna do? Well, actually, to make our lives slightly easier, let's go and select the wheel again. Face, press, not F, sorry. Press Shift S, then bring color cursor to selected. Awesome. Now select the cube and press collection to surfer. Cursor. Shift S again. There you go. You see? Bada bing, bada boom. And then we bring that bad boy over here. In edit mode, of course. Then we're gonna go select vertices. Bring it in like that. Cool. Now, the cube is in there. We're still in it. Press A. Bring it there. Suck these vertices, bring it down, then resize that shit, and make it nice and thin. There we go. Perfect. You see? Oh, crap. It's kind of sticking out here, so let's just bring it there. All right, what are we going to do? We're going to do our really cool friend loop cut. Select two cuts, S and Z, to move these, and bring it there, and on the top. It's a bit too much, so we bring it there. Make sure that there's enough space that the spokes are actually going into the wheel itself, just in case, you know. All right, so now we have that. We did that, so we're gonna go into select face, select this face, bring it down a bit, and then select these edges, then control B to bevel. And you bevel that shit. Let's do 3 segments. Doesn't have to be too much. Nothing fancy. It's just so it looks nice and sweet. All right. Now, what do we do? Well, remember how we set the origin point, the 3D cursor, right here? Well, that's gonna come out in our benefit. Go into edit mode, A. So you select all your vertices, and then you gotta use this quirky little thing called spin. You're gonna click on it, and whoa! Look at this. Now you're you got a bunch of circles. That's how we're gonna make our really nice and quirky spokes. So you just gotta count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the amount of spokes that your wheel has. Or if you're quirky like me, you can look it up on the internet and be like, how many spokes does this type of engine have? And then yada yada. So this one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I'm assuming 16 if I count to 13. 16 spokes. All right, perfect. So, you're gonna have to adjust your values here according, and it'll put you around like this. It'll be centering around your 3D cursor. Remember, this spin tool will spin around where the 3D cursor is. So if your 3D cursor is at 000 right here where it usually spawns, it's gonna be going around like that. And you're gonna have to do some changey magic number shit stuff. We don't want that. We don't want that happening. So remember, place your 3D cursor in the smack dab of where your wheel is, so that way it makes your life easier. Alright, and remember, you gotta adjust these values, the X, Y, or Z, to make it around. And, bada bing, bada boom, now we got a wheel. Alright, what are we missing? Well, what are we gonna do about the thing where the side rods connect? I got you, fam, don't you worry. So, we're gonna go into this transparent mode, select this shit, then go Shift D to bring the shit over here. Shift D, then press Y, so it's along that axis, and then just. Okay, let's just shift it down like that, you see? Bring it down. And yeah, we can work like that. Alright, and you're gonna see it did this really quirky thing where it went boom like that. So you can just easy fix, line it up, then bring it back there. Alright, cool, really quirky. Now you're gonna select the face, and you press F, and you're no, we want it at the very maximum. So just Z, Control Z, F again. Alright, we break the maximum at the top. Let's just make sure that what you want to do with the spokes is make sure like these you should be like connecting the faces on the furthermost point, so that way it doesn't look all weird and wonky and shit. So like that. No, wait. Okay, and I think we're good. Perfect. So now what are we gonna do? We have a bunch of empty space. We don't want that. Well, just gonna select this shit and F. No, wait. Missing F. Wait, again. Missing F. There we go. You see? Now it's all filled up and shit. And make sure you do that on the other side. Okay, just wait. And F. Bam, you see? So now it all filled up. Now, what are we gonna do? Well, we can, first of all, face, sucks face here, like, go inwards like this, insert face, like that, and then just make a stick, bam. Of course, it's a little bit more complicated than that, but that's just an oversimplification of how it works. You know, just, you can bevel that shit, make it nice. Hell, we just insert face, I don't know, extrude it inwards, insert face again, extrude it outwards, and bevel it. I don't know, do some quirky shit like that. Make it all fancy. Have fun with it, you know? Alright, this shit. Well, what are we gonna do? Well, you know, just inset. This is just like little bonus shit to make it all look pretty. I mean, I already showed off how to make the actual wheel itself. But yeah, that's, you got a wheel. Now, what about like the balances, the weight thingies, I think that's what they're called. Well, it's really simple. We're gonna go into the like this, and make sure you take note of where they start, right here and right here. So we're gonna go like this, bam and bam. Remember, shift and then control shift to select all faces in between. Then you're gonna go E to extrude, then like Z or across the axis you want. No, you don't. There we go. You see, that's an example. And then I guess if you got like this extra spaces right there, you know, you can just, I don't know, just select them, press F, fill in the faces. But wait, don't leave yet, because you're still one shit little thing that we're missing for the balances. Ah, shit balls, wait, hold up. And bam. Alright, what are we missing? It's looking a bit flat. So, what are we gonna do? We're gonna go like this. We're gonna select all our faces for the balances. And that little one down there. And we're just gonna extrude it outwards. Just a smidge. Not too much. Just a smidge. And there you go. That is an extremely simplified way of, let me just get rid of that, of how to make the wheel. You know, you can like make sure you also join together if you want. I don't know. I personally don't join them up until like right before I'm trying to export them or shit, or till like the very end. But hey, you can do if you want. I don't know. You know, make this shit like make it hollow. Now really quirky, and like, I don't know, if you want, you can texture it and shit, make it like blue for Thomas. The fuck, they're gonna make it blue. Look, it's now a blue. It's not the right shade of blue, but like, I don't care. Like, make it dark blue. I don't know, but that's how you make a wheel. I may have rushed through it, but hey, this video needs to be speedy and quick. So, yes, that is all. And hope you like this very scuffed, inefficient tutorial. If you want to see more shit like this of me trying to teach how I do shit in Blender, I don't know, put it in the comments or whatever. Follow my Twitter. I don't fucking know. Okay, thank you, and adios.